Well, his visit's much less frequent due to Sunday Night Football, but back for a 17th season as our, and I can't believe that, as our NFL analyst, former Lion, Jaguar, Bear, Michigan State Spartan, and of course, Greenville Yellow Jacket, Ty Hallock. Nice to see you again.
Well, it's good to see you. Hey, Jacket Pride, by the way, with a purple tie. We'll take that.
Right. I've still never figured out the purple with the yellow jackets from Greenville.
That's okay.
We'll explain that another
time. That's right.
Always hope going into a new season this year. And, you know, people ask me, I think it's the first time, maybe in my lifetime, that I like both the general manager and the coach together, and there's good reason for that, isn't there?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, look, at the end of the day, when you look at this process that they went through to get the coach they wanted in Matt Patricia, it all started with Bob Quinn. And Bob Quinn was a strategic placement by the Detroit Lions coming out of the New England Patriots, which, quite frankly, obviously is the modern-day dynasty of the National Football League. When you talk about what they've done personnel-wise and whom they've done it with, they haven't done it with a lot of flashy players. They haven't done it. They certainly have a quarterback. The Detroit Lions have a quarterback. So when you look at what it is they're doing and having both guys being really, quite frankly, born and bred in that system, it's all they know. You look at free agency, and I look at a bunch of guys that they're bringing in that are not, you know, the A guys. They're the worker bees. They're the guys that are going to do a lot of the things you need to do, special teams, backup linemen, a linebacker that will be able to make some plays. I think this is great because it is the first time, even way back in the day when I was there in 1993, you certainly had a GM and you had a president and you had the William Clay Ford Sr. and Jr. involved. And in this scenario, they really are kind of giving Bob Quinn the room he needs to make the moves with the people he wants to. And Matt Patricia was certainly high on that list. They went out, they got their guy. And I think with the moves they're making and having two guys that are on the same page will pay great dividends. We should be excited, in my opinion. This is a tough schedule coming out of the gates.
Yes, it
However,
is.
I just like where they're at in terms of the front office and the coaching staff being in the same place.
Lots of changes here. One thing Bob Quinn has done is attacked an area he needed to be fixed. And they said they needed to fix the running game. They've done that through the draft, obviously, and through the coaches that they're bringing in. Your thoughts on what could be a power running game, which we haven't seen in a long, long time?
Well, I think this is going to start up front with the Hog Mollies, right? We talk about those guys. Probably haven't had that term. We'll get Larry all fired up with the Hog Molly quote of the day. Those are those big guys up front. And Frank Ragnow, the guy they got out of Arkansas right out of the gate, that's a center guard type, but certainly a physical, tough player, somebody that can help set the tone, being a good addition to Decker and some of the guys they have, Glasgow certainly at center. But they have flexibility in that first draft pick. And then when you talk about the running back from Auburn, unbelievable pick in my opinion. This Kerryon is going to be a great player. He's a physical back. They go out in free agency and grab a blunt. They're basically telling you that they're going to run the football. And Jeff Davison, who's going to coach these Hog Mollies up front, is a former NFL lineman. He's been several years in the National Football League as a player. And now as a coach, he's been involved. Think about this. In the same time frame that the Detroit Lions had 100-yard rushers, he's been coaching teams that have done 6,300-yard rushing deals. So he gets the gap schemes. He gets the zone schemes. He's going to be able to implement that and also show the relevant experience of being a player. How do we run these gap schemes? How do we run these zone schemes? What are we going to do technique-wise? Here's something that I learned, and probably it'll be a good player-coach relationship. And as anybody knows on offense, it all starts with that running game. And once they do, I think we'll get to those playmakers that everybody knows and loves that the Detroit Lions have, including their good quarterback with a strong arm.
Yeah, and a guy who's had, 700-yard rushers in his entire career. How good can Matthew Stafford be with the running game? And you mentioned literally one of the best wideout groups, and perhaps Kenny Galladay makes that an even a better group this year.
Yeah, in my opinion, I mean, as I look at some of the guys that should highlight this particular season and even take off further, I personally think Kenny Galladay's at the top of that deal. He is long, he is fast, he gets vertical, he runs his routes well, he's going to be seasoned, he's gotten through a season, he had a little bit of injury last year, but the maturity that he'll have, in my opinion, and from what you hear inside, his hunger to be a better receiver is only going to pay dividends. And when you got Golden Tate around you, good solid veteran to help you with those work habits, help you with those route running skills, Marvin Jones, the same thing, I think this is an opportunity for him to really stand out in this particular season.
Ragnow should play a big part in the role. He's a big, big guy up there, but he's not your favorite draft pick. Who is?
No, my favorite draft pick comes out of the fourth round, which is Deshaun Hand, another Alabama defensive lineman. He looks the part. He's physical. He was a very high-rated player coming out of high school, had solid production at Alabama. I think there's a little bit of question mark about kind of you know, it's not a question about his upside. It's a question about, is he going to push himself in that upside? But listen, everybody's a little bit different. When you're in the college game, is very different than the pro game, and the opportunity to do nothing but football may very well help him. And I think he's a guy that could have easily been in the second round and has all the physical tools and talents. It'll be interesting to me how he matures and how they bring him along. I think this draft class is really good. You know, Tracy Walker, the safety, fills a need. We've got good seasoned veteran guys there, but we need a younger athletic guy. He comes out of Louisiana Lafayette. I think he's a really good one. So I think when you, again, you go back to the beginning of what we're talking about the coach and the GM being on the same page, drafting guys that are going to be physical, tough, fast, and the things that you're going to need to do for the Detroit Lions, I think there's some good signs here that this particular season, again, I think the schedule's tough, but these guys being on the same page and getting the players they want, it's a really good sign for Lion fans.
Yeah, a lot of the emphasis made on offense. The defense is what a lot of people think Matt Patricia is here to fix. We'll talk about that in just a moment. More with Ty Hallock straight ahead on Sports Overtime. Welcome back to Sports Overtime. A lot of the talk has been about the offense, but the reason Matt Patricia's here is to fix that defense. There's been, you know, do we have enough edge rushers? Will it be a 4-3 or a 3-4 defense? Usually it's been a 4-3 in Detroit, a little bit mixed when your time there. They say it's not going to be either. It's going to be multiple fronts, kind of the Patriot way.
Well, and I think what's interesting about that is based on your personnel, right? One of the concerns going into the season will be the edge pass rush. You got Ziggy Ansah, but who else is going to step up
right. And
actually be that next guy? And if you don't have that, then the multiple fronts really plays into that. And Paul Pasqualoni, who is the defensive coordinator, this guy's been coaching for about 40 years. He's been a D coordinator, been a head coach. Guy's been around a long time. I think it's very crucial, in my opinion, it's a very crucial hire and a smart hire by Matt Patricia, because what he gets is a very seasoned guy who's probably seen and done it all, and Matt Patricia is going to be able to kind of pull those strings and say, this is exactly what I want, and you need to implement it, and he can do it where he can spend some time, additional time on the offensive end. If you read anything about how camp has been going, Matt Patricia has been all over the place. You're able to do that when you have a 40-year guy as a defensive coordinator. Mm-hmm. If you got a younger coordinator or somebody that's similar to your age and maybe is learning things like you are, you don't have that flexibility. So I think this hire at defensive coordinator is a good thing. And I also think the multiple fronts. I can tell you on a weekly basis, in the National Football League, in college, and in high school, you are typically going against a single front, 3-4 or the four, some form of 4-2-5, 4-3, whatever that case may be. And it simplifies your game plan. When you go in and you've got a counting system for linemen and you have protections that are based and set on an odd front versus an even, it can get complicated if during the course of the game you're looking at one thing you think and it's actually the opposite and vice versa. So it's going to be something that obviously you got to get the team on board with that. You got to get guys rotating in. This will speak to the depth of the Lions, by the way, because they're going to need multiple guys in those different fronts, I'm sure, to be able to get out, get after it, and make sure that they know mentally how to take off and be the pro they want to be.
Yeah, for the young kids, we always show Ty as a tight end, but people forget, came in as a linebacker, actually, with the Lions out of Michigan State. No change of the defense, maybe more than what they've done with the linebacking group this year. Who do you like that they brought in?
Well, I definitely like Kennard. I mean, and he, when I look at the outside linebacker play we've had over the last few years, we've had some decent guys. He's a solid football player with the New York Giants. Again, from a free agency perspective, he didn't have the highest grade in the world, but he just seems to do his job. Mm-hmm. That fits right in with that influence of the New England Patriots mm-hmm. that you'll get with Matt Patricia. It's solid. It's good. The middle linebacker should be significantly better. You know, a year from
good
now.
Player, isn't he?
I mean, Jerod Davis is just a solid player. Very tough, very physical, can run sideline to sideline. I expect him to do well. And the secondary is really anchored with some age and some youth, which I think will bode well because guys will be learning, but there are guys back there that can help kind of drive the bus, as you will. When I played with William White back in the day from Ohio State, who came to the Detroit Lions, was a free safety. He always talked about driving the bus as a free safety. You always are making calls, you're always making the checks, and you're always teaching everybody around you how we have to do things based on coverage. And I think we have those guys in place. Now for the young guys to learn that, see that, and be developed, along with a defensive coach who I guarantee you, yes, he'll spend some time down in the offensive end, but he's going to spend a lot of time with that defense dialing in on what it is he wants to get done. I think it bodes well for the defense of the Detroit Lions.
All right, switch back to the other side of the ball. We've got about 30 seconds left, but tight end's a big question area. What's going to happen there? Great-looking rookie from last year, didn't do much on the field. What do you think?
Well, I think they're really looking at Michael Roberts for his flexibility. They got three tight ends now. They filled that position. It certainly shows you they're going to run the football, but I think they're going to also throw the football, and Roberts has had that in his past at Toledo. I think he's going to be an exciting one to watch.
Right, I'm not asking you predictions. It's way too early, but you feeling hopeful this year?
I feel hopeful, but I will tell you, looking at the schedule, it is tough.
Yeah, especially out the gate, those first five.
You bet.
Two of the first three on national television, one here against the Patriots in week 3 on Wood TV 8. Thanks for joining us, Ty. Appreciate it very much, and I look forward to a great season.
You bet.